After halting the construction work, contractor noted that they could not continue working without resources despite appeals to the government. During a field visit at the airport in February this year, the State Minister for Works and Transport, Fred Byamukama, said the contractor was suspected to be convening with some top government officials to swindle money meant for the construction of the airport. He added that the contractor, under unclear circumstances, demanded for extra 126 billion shillings from the government to help them complete works at the airport, yet the government earlier allocated the contractor all the money it needed to construct the airport.
The problem where this airport by now, we should be commissioning some of the works which they have done, so that by June this year, they hand over. We removed some of the items because of funds. The project, the civil works involved the 64 million euros, but came in a challenge because of the mafiaism we have in this country. People want to connive with the contractor for the government of Uganda to lose over 28 million euros, which is about 126 billion. That's a lot of money. In the name of variation of prices.
Amos Morisa, the communications manager at SBC, then said that during the COVID-19 pandemic, the contractor faced a lot of challenges, especially in the variations of prices for the airport construction materials, yet they had not planned for such anomalies that he said went beyond their budget. In an interview with Urban TV in Hoima City, Morisa revealed that they have resumed work after the contractor and government reached a consensus.
We received the communication from the ministry, and depending on the negotiations, there has been talks and meetings since the last time when we had laid down tools. But now we've reached a consensus, we've reached a point where we have agreed, the parties, the consultancy, the contractor and the ministry who is employing us have reached a point where they have agreed, and now we've got a communication, so we have resumed work normally.
Despite halting the construction works for a month, Morisa says they are optimistic that they will meet the set deadline for the construction works to be complete, so that by June this year, they hand over the airport to the government.
We only halted the work for like 1 month, and we hope to double our efforts to cover the period that was that we are not working. So it is not going to affect our timelines, and it may not affect the expected completion date. Because now that we have resumed, we are going to double efforts in many sections, and we shall make sure we complete the work in the time we are given.
Michael Chakashari, the Hoima Deputy Resident District Commissioner, noted that workers will be called back in phases according to the work available.
Kabale International Airport, or Hoima International Airport, had suspended the activities and had laid off the workers. But after the minister's visit yesterday, it was resolved that they are going to start working again, and the workers are going to be recalled in phases. So at least we are now sure that the airport will be complete.
The 307 million euros airport financed by Standard Chartered Bank will have a capacity of accommodating 4 cargo planes at a go, a fire station, an apron, a control tower, accommodation facilities for the workers and parallel runways, taxiway, air rescue firefighting house, power substation house, communications and navigation systems, perimeter fence and air ground illumination system, among others. The airport is expected to be handed over in June this year. Report compiled by Godfrey Muhumza for the news.